Hi, I'm Deborah Atkinson, and this is actually part of the set for the Flipping 50 TV show. And you can go and give me your question or challenge at flipping50tv.com. And if I choose your question for the show, I'm going to give you some great gifts and goodies. Even if I don't, I'm going to give you my Muscles in Minutes guide. But that's not why we're here. I want to talk about why, if you want to lose weight, you want to lift heavy weight. So a couple of reasons. One, a really recent study showed us that you can boost your metabolism in 10 weeks based on study participants. And these are men and women both who went from couch to exercise. So they were previously sedentary and they made this much progress. They boosted their metabolism by 7%. So imagine that. And this isn't exactly, but you can eat 7% more without gaining weight. So if that sounds good to you, or if you don't eat 7% more and you eat the same, or even you eat better, not necessarily less or fewer calories, but better and higher quality food, you're gonna make 7% more progress. Boost your metabolism by 7% in 10 weeks. That was by exercising with heavy weight training twice a week, and not for a long period of time. It's more about the how and the exercises that you do. So you're going to work major muscle groups, not that it has to take an hour. So we're talking about quality, not quantity. So what else? Size. So when you lift weights in particular, compared to doing cardiovascular exercise, for instance, you're actually going to be able to change your size much easier because muscle gets more compact. Now, you can do cardiovascular exercise and you may actually be a smaller version of your current self, but I'm gonna jump down here and tie this into proportion. If you're not happy with the size of your hips compared to the size of your waist or the size of your shoulders, and you'd love to have more of an hourglass figure either that you used to have or you never had, weight training is the way to make that happen. You can change your proportion by changing how you emphasize your different body parts with certain exercises. And by changing the way that you exercise with strength training, you have a better chance of changing your body shape. So it's not just, yeah, you can be a smaller size, but you can also be a more toned and powerful and dynamic smaller size, not just smaller and constantly worried about whether you're going to gain that weight back, because that's the other problem, right? It's not losing it, but you actually have to do more to maintain weight loss than you did to lose it in the first place. It's not as if you can go back to whatever you were doing before that caused you to gain the weight in the first place. The last one I want to talk about is cellulite. By the time we're 50, and for a lot of people, it was by the time they were 40, for some it was 30, and for some, it's been their whole life, their entire adult life. They may have had to deal with cellulite, and cellulite doesn't discriminate. You can be extremely fit and still have cellulite. Part of it is genetic, so yes, you can blame your parents for this one, but not entirely, because the rest of the components are all up to you. How you eat. So you need to reduce some of those sugars that you're getting because they actually help you glob on that type of fat that shows you the cellulite and that dimpled skin. And it can be anywhere. It can be on your upper arms, biceps, in the back of your arms, and your triceps, or what we call the bat wings. It can be on your belly, your hips, and your thighs. And for most women, it almost always tends to be hips and thighs, but it may also be somewhere else. So if you're lifting heavy and you're watching what you eat, drinking a lot of water and having a little caffeine, you actually can help yourself decrease your appearance of cellulite. Now, cellulite is just fat, but what happens is when you've got cellulite and bad habits, or you're not exercising in the right way, those fat cells expand and your skin is getting thinner. It's not as tight, as taut as it used to be. And so those fat globules that are growing and expanding are more visible. So we can't necessarily tighten and tone your skin as much on the surface, but we can increase the tone of the muscle, improve the health of the fascia. And if you want to learn more about that, go back to flipping50tv.com. Shoot me a question or a challenge that you're struggling with the most, and you'll get immediately, just for taking the time and the effort, Muscles in Minutes, my guide to 20 exercises, the how-to, what it looks like to start, what it looks like when you finish, and tips for modifying if you have a knee or a hip joint you need to work around, or you want to make it a little bit more intense, I've got you covered. You can get that plus the bonus section that talks about cellulite and how to deal with it. So I hope to see you on the other side. Go grab that book and let's flip 50 together.